Good afternoon, everyone. Hope everyone's having a blasted build. My name is Annamalai, and I'm part of the GeForce product team here to talk to you about two things. First, we'll be discussing the latest updates for accelerating PC applications on RTX GPUs. And second, we'll be discussing how developers can experiment with generative AI on the RTX PCs. We all know that Gen AI is reshaping PC software with entirely new experiences, from writing assistants to agents to creative tools, digital humans, and many more use cases. But experimenting and deploying AI-enabled features within apps poses unique challenges for developers on the PC. First, developers want to get started quickly with AI experimentation. They need easy tools that help with prototyping AI features and use cases. Once the experimentation phase is done, Windows application developers are struggling to deploy these AI features within Windows apps due to the unique constraints on PC. Some of the challenges are that computer requirements for useful, high-quality models are pretty high, and you need high compute performance to deliver fast, snappy, low-latency inferencing on the PC. The PC ecosystem is fragmented. There are many different silicon types on the PC, from CPUs to NPUs and GPUs. And on the software side, there are many libraries, frameworks, and SDKs and models for developers to choose from. And developers, when they kind of piece all these things together, often deal with many different complexities and dependency challenges. And at times, to solve these challenges in the near term, devs are building custom experiences. And over time, that kind of adds a maintenance burden and slows progress. And lastly, developers need to continuously package and update to the latest software packages and components to keep their applications up to date to deliver great experiences to the users. Here is NVIDIA's AI PC software stack that helps solve some of these challenges, all the way from experimentation to application deployment on Windows. It all starts with our hardware, the RTX GPUs within laptops and desktop PCs that provide the best performance for AI. It's been built with AI in mind for seven years and more. We have dedicated tensor cores that accelerate matrix multiplication for AI math. And to take full advantage of the tensor cores, we make available our acceleration libraries. CUDA for general programming and our AI inferencing library called TensorRT. AI developers can use these components to make their AI run faster on the PC. For developers using AI models and looking to build purpose-built AI models and bring that into apps, we have an array of SDKs and models available, from DLSS and optics for 3D and graphics use cases, to RTX video and Maxine for multimedia use cases, and NVIDIA ACE for digital human tech, Nemotron for our LLM tech, Riva for our speech tech, all helping with Gen AI use cases. And you and devs can take these into apps as SDKs or plugins, as well as start developing with some of these tools and models with the NVIDIA NIMS for quick, rapid experimentation. On top of all this, we have over 750 AI apps and games accelerated on the RTX GPU today. This week, Microsoft introduced an exciting update that solves many of the application deployment challenges that we discussed earlier, called Windows ML. This is a runtime that offers a common unified API that's built on top of Onyx runtime and works with specific execution providers of the different IHVs. In the case of NVIDIA RTX GPUs, it's TensorRT. Windows ML automatically picks what execution provider to use depending on the hardware available as well as the developer's specified application requirements, and then downloads all the necessary files for that hardware. This way, you get to bring your own custom Onyx model into Windows ML, which offers broad compatibility, maximum performance, and support for many different model types. Another key innovation in Windows ML is the decoupling of the execution provider from the inference backend, allowing for over-the-air updates to be sent by each vendor. This means that NVIDIA can improve TensorRT over time and provide updates to the Windows PCs without requiring apps having to update each component. Alongside Windows ML, NVIDIA announced a new version of TensorRT for RTX GPUs. It's been redesigned from the ground up to facilitate deployment on RTX, And it supports just-in-time compilation of models with the new TensorRT engine. Now you can get specific hardware-specific optimizations on the target user's GPU without having to do any additional work. It's 2 times faster than the earlier DirectML version and 8 times smaller, making it easier to package this within applications. TensorRT will be the execution provider for Windows ML on RTX PCs, and it's available in preview today. Go check it out. And it's also going to be available as standalone SDK shortly. Let me now tell you a little bit about how TensorRT works. It uses a two-stage process. The first step occurs ahead of time before application startup. It can ingest any ONNX model, unpack the ONNX graph, and optimizes all the math for maximum performance all within 30 seconds on the CPU. Then it creates an intermediate engine that's a few kilobytes in size without including the model weights. Next, when the application is ready for startup, we go into the just-in-time compilation process. TensorRT uses the intermediate engine generated in the previous process alongside the ONNX model to optimize the kernels on the GPU to deliver maximum performance. All this is done within 15 seconds, and this step only needs to happen once on the end user's device. Once it happens once, the kernel execution paths are stored on cache for subsequent runs so that it's super snappy at next run. This advanced process leads to an average of 1.5 times speed up for AI model execution on the RTX PC for many, many common models. In larger models, we see even larger speed ups, up to 2x for stable diffusion workloads. Learn more about TensorRT at developer.nvidia.com. Shifting gears a little bit, let me tell you about how you can quickly experiment with building AI workflows on NVIDIA RTX with NVIDIA NIM microservices. NVIDIA NIM is a containerized model that runs on top of Windows subsystem for Linux on RTX. The NIM model contains everything that you need to get going with generative AI quickly. It's built upon the same performance optimizations that we spoke about with TensorRT, and it's easy to use with streamlined APIs. The workflow is very similar to how you deploy models in the cloud, or how you run models in the cloud today. It's compatible with top tools like LangChain and LangFlow for agentic UI use cases, and most importantly, the same package, workflows, and architectures that you develop on the PC can run across the breadth of NVIDIA's platform, from cloud to PC, all within Windows subsystem for Linux. You can start development in one platform and move across the platforms easily. We're also bringing the top models across different categories, from LLMs to speech to image models to RAG models and more from the community as well as NVIDIA to help you get going with this quickly. Out of the box with a NIM, you get optimal performance that's both optimized at the hardware and software layers. In this slide, we're showing two images that's built with the Flux model. Flux is an interesting image generation model and works by chaining together 4 different types of models. On the left side, you see an image generated with PyTorch natively, the version you can get from Hugging Face. And the right side, you see an image that's generated with NIM. As you can see, they look pretty identical to each other. However, with the NIM, you get FP4 acceleration taking advantage of the latest hardware acceleration capabilities, meaning that you get 3 times the performance at half the VRAM for this model. Let's now take a quick look at NIMs in action. First, you can go to build.nvidia.com and explore all the NIMs that are available today. Let's take a look at DeepSeek Distal Llama 8B. Let's try it out in the API. When you're ready to deploy to RTX, you hit deploy to RTX. The first step is to install your prereqs and enter into WSL2. Once you enter into your WSL2 within the terminal, you can quickly copy the API key and run a run command. This command will download all the bits from our systems onto the user's GPU that's optimized for the specific GPU. And within a few short seconds, you should see that model up and running on localhost, ready for you to use within your workflows. The next step is let's just quickly test the NIM. Let's run a curl command against the REST API that we just stood up. And pretty quickly, we were able to see DeepSeek running on local RTX PC. This shows the breadth of the NIM ecosystem on PC. First, we have a variety of model types and interesting community and NVIDIA-built models from language to images and many more. Next, we have complex workflows and reference examples that we call NVIDIA AI Blueprints that showcase how you can chain together many of these NIMs to build workflows. Some examples of this include ChatRTX for a chatbot reference, 3D guided generative AI to create high fidelity images that you have control over using a 3D asset, and Project GAssist, which showcases an example for agent and tool calling on the PC. And to top it off, we also have a broad ecosystem of model partners, developer tools, and applications that support and offer NIMs today on RTX. You can get started today on build.nvidia.com. Here are some SDKs which can be used for integrating specific AI into your PC apps today. We have DLSS and optics for 3D and graphics, to RTX video and Maxine for multimedia, and Riva and Ace for digital human and speech tech. Today, there's over 750 AI games and apps that are accelerated in RTX today. This summarizes our full suite of offerings for AI development to deployment on the PC. For ISV application deployment, we have Windows ML for bringing your ONNX model into your PC app. We also have purpose-built AI SDKs to bring AI models into the apps, and we support the top community frameworks on RTX, like Llama CPP for LM-specific prototyping. We also have NVIDIA NIMS for generative AI experimentation and workflow building. And lastly, we support PyTorch for in-framework model experimentation. We offer choice and acceleration across all the top frameworks for all your needs from end-to-end on RTX GPUs. Here is a quick snapshot of how you can use NVIDIA GPUs for all your AI development needs on local PC. First, we have RTX AI PCs for quick experimentation and inferencing, which offers up to 25 times faster inferencing than a Mac. We also have the RTX Pro workstations, which is great for AI application development, which offers up to 14 times faster fine-tuning than a Mac. And shortly, we'll have DGX Spark that's available for AI model development and fine-tuning. You can fit really large models for both AI inferencing and fine-tuning using the 128 gigabytes of unified memory on system. In summary, this is Windows AI on RTX. You can deploy PC AI on RTX within apps using Windows ML and TensorRT for RTX. You can get started quickly by building and experimenting with AI workflows on the PC with NIMs and blueprints. And we have a choice of devices for all your AI development and deployment needs on RTX PC today. Learn more about RTX AI on developer.nvidia.com and join our Discord community to stay up to date with the latest information and get help from NVIDIA experts on all your AI PC developer needs. Thanks for joining us today. Happy to chat at the booth or after the session. Thank you.